All right, back at the action on hand. Looks like Schoolboy 112-16 BC done with their parade lap in the gate right now, getting ready to get this one started one more time. Out on the track, Schoolboy 112-16 BC. Looks like Jaleek Swole with a 1-2 and total of 3 points right now out front in the lead in this one. Derek Drake with a 3-3 sitting with 6 points. Carson Brown comes in with a 7-1, giving him 8 points. Carter Halpin a 4-8 for 12 points, tied with Pierce Brown with a 2-10 for 12. Gabe Gutierrez in the sixth position right now, leading in with a 13-4 and 17 points. Brock Pappy sitting in the seventh position with 11-12-23. Justin Thompson, 14-11-25. Chase Fosnott, 17-9-26. And Parker Mashburn comes in the 10th place with a 6-21 with 27. Rodney, I'm telling you, what we just witnessed right there by Terry Bossard was absolutely incredible. The emotion down on the podium was absolutely phenomenal, but the ride itself, I just can't comment on how amazing it truly was.
It really was. It was a lot of fun to watch, a lot of fun to call, and I am certainly glad I got to witness that one. Skate down on our next one right now. It is the Schoolboy 112, the 16-year-olds. It looks like Justin Thompson, the 61 Yamaha rider, has taken the early lead and the Bell Helmets hole shot. He is currently sitting in eighth place coming into this moto. He has a 14 and an 11. And we got Jaleek Swole back in the number two spot. And he's already trying to make hay while the sun shines out there for him. And Swole coming into this with a 1-2. Now possible one, looking at the championship. And the 91 machine of Carson Brown on that Husqvarna looking at a 7-1-1 himself right now. So he is just ahead of Jaleek Swole. So Carson Brown takes over the lead. Swole, I believe, drops back to the number two spot. So your early leader out there, that 61 of Justin Thompson's got his hands full in the early part of this Schoolboy 1 Moto 3.
Wow, I know one thing. Starting off exactly like they left off in this class, fast and furious up front. Swole happened to make a couple quick moves in the last moto. Now these two guys right here, Carson Brown and Swole, picking up where they left off. Brown going to the inside trying to protect it. Looks like Swole following him through and up and over the Rocky Mountain they go. Brown trying to protect that inside line. Swole not going to be able to follow, so has to choose an alternate route up and over that Kawasaki jump in the middle. Headed down past the lake right now, and looks like Brown swapping just a bit. Swole on the gas, wide open around the outside. Both feet up. Both guys want that inside line. Swole able to make it happen. Will it stick? Brown coming around the outside, not letting up. Swole out jumping him over that little triple and up and over the tunnel jump.
Through the tunnel love, now down in front of the billboard. Jaleek Swole taking over the lead in this one. It's dropping back to the number two spot, Carson Brown. Colton Eigenman in the number three position. Brock Pappy is fourth, Palmer Neely in fifth. Grant Harlan, the number 43 and sixth. Justin Thompson, who got the hole shot, drops back to seventh. There's Pierce Brown, the 63 and eighth. Marco Canella rounding out ninth. And Parker Mashburn is your 10th place ride to kick things off here in the Schoolboy 1 class.
Right now, though, Jaleek Swole trying to make a break for it. Carson Brown trying to keep him honest. They're coming through the short chutes right now, headed back into the Ten Commandments. Swole made a lot of time up there. Last time, look at this. Crossing over. Brown now going to the outside. Looks like we're back to the inside for Swole. These guys now almost side by side as they come back into this rhythm section, leading back into Storyland, but Swole still able to maintain control of that lead, turning it back up. But look at this.
Whoa.
Brown trying to come to the inside. Brown been working those insides now for a lap and a half. Feeling real comfortable inside there, Rodney.
He most certainly is, and I'll tell you what, Carson Brown is hungry for this moto win. He wants to take this away from the 30 of Jaleek Swole. Swole coming into this one with a 1-2 situation. The scenario is that the national championship's looking like his. But Brown also coming into this one with at least one moto win. He got the second moto win, but finished seventh in moto one and in that muddy race. We got a battle going on right now between the 14 and 34. That's for the third place position. Pappy on the 14. Colton Eigenman on the 34 right now, as these riders now make their way through the heart of this Loretta Lynn race course, now into the Thor Beach area.
Pappy trying to carry that momentum, not working for him, actually getting slowed up just a bit right there. The number 34 machine, Augman, able to still maintain that position, but Pappy looking to go inside one more time as they work their way underneath of the tower.
Look behind Pappy, though. The 63 machine is right there on his rear wheel, or was.
Oh, man.
When they came by the finish line. Whoa, Pappy nearly slid out there. That's going to give Pierce Brown the opportunity to make up and shave off at least a few microseconds there. And it's also going to give Carson Brown, the 91, Colton Eigemann, the 34, a little bit of breathing room right there in that third place position. So it's going to heat back up, but I think when it does, it's going to be two riders approaching the 34 of Eigemann, and he's going to have Pierce Brown and Brock Pappy both to deal with.
Yeah, he's going to be feeling that soon because both of these guys are pushing each other right now. Pappy using all kinds of different lines out there right now. Eigemann trying to do his best to hold him off. But look at this. Holy cow, Rodney. Looks like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, about 10 riders in the commandments right now. So one rider per commandment as they make their way through.
So it was Pierce Brown in fifth. Marco Canella was sixth. Grant Harlan in seventh. Eighth, Justin Thompson. Ninth, Palmer Neely. And 10th, Carter Halpain. Halpain's got some work to make up here, it looks like. Jesse Flock is 11th aboard the 67. There's Chase Fosnot in 12th. Devin Simonson is 13th. Trey Fagert is 14th. Johnny Garcia in 15th. Tanner Ward, Ethan Mann, Luke Neese, Gabe Gutierrez, and Christian Fernandez rounding out your top 20. The 34 and 14 continue to wage war. It is Pappy still trying to show a wheel right now to Eigemann, it looks like here. Megawatt, as they again approach the big sandy beach. Your leader out front here is Jaleek Swole. Carson Brown not far behind him. And here comes Pierce Brown once again.
Pierce Brown's going to let Pappy and Eigemann get locked together there, and he's going to try to take advantage of that situation right now. It looks like Pappy's still trying to force this issue down there on the inside. But that
Brown is on the outside now, taking over the number three spot. Brown gets cut down, shut down for just a moment, but he's got the inside going over the Tunnel of Love and heading up in front of the billboard.
It's a drag race now, Rodney. Who's going to be able to make it around this 180 bend? It's still Brown riding it. They call that sliding the rail right there, climbing out of that berm. And holy cow, Pappy still back there. Brown going up over the high road. Pappy deciding to follow, but Eigemann stuck right in the middle there. Now he's taking the low road, coming back at him through the short chutes right now. Now Brown going over into the inside line, riding defensively.
Wow, a 7-second gap up to the second place position. I don't think that Jaleek Swole and Carson Brown realize what kind of furiosity is going on behind them. Eigemann, Brown, Pappy, and now Marco Canella.
Got a new player, Rodney. Look at that.
It's the 46 machine.
Puts himself right in there, picks up the position. Nice, clean pass. Now he sets himself off after Eigemann.
So Marco Canella kind of seeing what's going on, the ferocity of that particular position and battle, so he wanted to get in and play a little bit in that. Carter Halpain is going to be another one to watch out for. He was 3.5 seconds back, but wouldn't surprise me to see him make some major gains and actually be right in that position. We got the battle for the lead back on. I've been keeping an eye on this one as the number 30, Jaleek Swole, holds on to that, but Carson Brown is still within striking distance and has been. And look at that big whip over the Kawasaki Camelback there into the Thor Beach. I believe that second place ride of Carson Brown is having some fun out here on this racetrack right now.
Wow, you got to be relaxed, you got to be confident, and you better be having fun to pull a move like that in these circumstances, running second place in a moto of a Loretta Lynn's.
You got a little bit of showtime in him there, I think.
So you better believe that.
I heard Jeremy McGrath talking about being a show-off. I think Carson Brown's a bit of a show-off himself there. But you know what? He's in a good position to be able to do it. And if he can capitalize and use that that incentive, that confidence that he's riding with right now to get around Jaleek Swole, that is going to be a big statement that he makes. There's Pierce Brown now up to the number three spot. So we could end up with a Swole-Brown-Brown battle coming up soon. Back with the intense battle back there with Brock Pappy, Marco Canella, and Colton Eigemann. Eigemann has dropped off to the sixth place position, and there is Carter Halpain. He's in that mix as well, and we're right back at it up front with Swole and Brown for the number one spot.
Brown not letting up, relentless in his approach right now, taxing Swole's every nerve right now, testing his ability to focus forward, but Brown right now just trying anything he can to wear down the number 30 of Jalik Swole.
Oh, look at the line choices of Carson Brown. These are calculated. He doesn't appear to even be pushing it really right now at this particular point. I mean, he looks to be riding on a completely different level than we've seen him ride all week long.
Looks very, very relaxed and comfortable right now, Rodney. Looks like feeling his flow right now. The pace.
Look at that.
Anywhere near what you would expect to see these guys leaving the rest of the class like this. These guys absolutely picking up and taking off. So
you say that, but they're turning 157 lap times. You know, oftentimes the smoothest riders are turning the fastest lap times. They don't look the fastest, but they're running the smoothest and most consistent laps, and that's what's happening right here. We got a 159, 158 for Swole and for Brown right there. Nearly side-by-side here past the finish line, up and over the Tunnel of Love we go. Swole has got about two bike lengths as they head toward the billboard section now. Call it about four or five as he really found some traction out there.
It's just incredible to me that these guys able to bring it back time after time and go again, and one more time, here we go.
Brown getting a wheel almost underneath there on the inside of that, and that's going to set him up to try to make the pass through the Bell Moto Forest now. Winding through the forest, now heading toward the short chutes. He's going the shortest way around this racetrack he possibly can, and that's trying to find all those short lines. Got himself set up. I think he might have it if he can beat him to the turn right here. We might see a pass, and that's it. The 91 of Carson Brown threading the needle. It's a drag race through the Ten Commandments now. He's got the line coming out, and Carson Brown is your new leader now, looking at a 7-1-1. Now, that right there is, of course, a little bit far back as far as the championship title goes with he and Jalik Swole, because Swole was looking at a 1-2-2. He's going to score an overall 5. So right now, Brown 7-1-1 is a 9, so there's 4 points that separate them. But though he may not be winning the championship, this third moto is a mission statement and a very big statement, an explanation point as far as the national championship is concerned. And when you do it in head-to-head battling in perfect conditions as far as this racetrack is concerned, you know you've accomplished something, and folks watching that race know as well. So the national championship, though it would be some great bragging rights, I think this particular battle right here is going to be the one that really helps elevate his notoriety throughout the industry.
Wow. And we get where Derek Drake started this moto in second place, I believe, going in now in the 17th position, Rodney.
Yeah, he had a 3-3 going into this moto.
Wow.
If we look at the overall scores right now, here's the way it breaks down. Derek Drake, whom we mentioned there in the 17th place position in second coming into this moto. We were watching him right there for a moment. That's going to take him out of contention for the championship. He was in contention for it, but that third moto, I tell you, it's the breaker right there sometimes. Right now, though, if it finishes the way it is, Jalik Swole's 1-2-2 is 5. That's good enough for the win, with Carson Brown going 7-1-1 for 9. Impressive rides by Carson Brown. Pierce Brown, a 2-10-3. He's going to look at a third place overall. Carter Halpain, a 4-8-6 right now for fourth. And Derek Drake, the 33, who is back in 17th, he still will get a top five overall, even though I know he was thinking championship coming into this moto.
Rodney, you know we predicted it. We talked about what might happen in these final motos. But when you look at what we've seen over the last few motos and the ability for these guys to close the gap, these guys to answer the call, and, of course, for some of these leaders to defend that position, just been absolutely what we've expected, what we predicted. And I want to tell you something. I can't be more impressed than I am right now by taking a look at this 91 of Carson Brown. Carson Brown rode in that second place for the majority of this race, threw everything but the kitchen sink at Swole, then became very patient, used his mind, started using the tactics that brought him into this position to start with coming into this moto, and now look, back out front and pulling away.
Well, I tell you what, it was very calculated. I never seen anything look so, the kid was just on a mission, and he looked like he was not going to be denied as we watched Jalik Swole, who is going to win this national title with a 1-2-2 here at Loretta Lynn's. And in the closing moments here, 13 and a half minutes, I believe we'll be seeing possibly the white flag this time around. No, these are 20-minute motos now, so we got a little bit longer to go for these guys in the Schoolboy 1 class now.
But Brown, man, hats off to that guy. Just relentless in the attack, absolutely relentless.
Okay, so we might be actually looking at 18-minute motos, but regardless, we are nearing the completion as we are at 14 minutes on the race clock right now.
Like I said, Rodney, we expected this out of some of these motos. You know, just incredible action last time around with Wagner and Bossert in that last moto. But what we're about to witness right here, look at this. Tripling up and out now,
starting to feel
really good about himself, the number 91.
You know, count out the number 30 of Jalik Swole just yet. I think he is only about 4.1 seconds back. Carson Brown, that's a pretty big gap, but we saw Carson Brown make that gap up, so who's to say that Swole can't do the same thing, especially when some lap traffic starts to come into play.
All right, need a few more people back at the registration office. Mason Hume, Maxwell Kiefer, Nathan Hexum, Carolina Electric, and Laura Baker. So Mason Hume, Maxwell Kiefer, Nathan Hexum, Carolina Auto Electric, and Laura Baker. You all are needed at the registration office.
Well, taking a look at the top 10 in this third moto, we've been talking a lot about the overall and those riders up front, but it's Carson Brown, Jalik Swole, Pierce Brown, Marco Canella now the 46 of the fourth, Carter Halpine in fifth aboard the 82, Brock Pappy is sixth, seventh, the 67 of Jesse Flock, eighth place Justin Thompson, he is on the 61, he grabbed the Bell Helmets Hole Shot Award. Colton Eigenman has dropped back to ninth place aboard the 34, and Grant Harlan rounds out the top 10. Then you got names like Connor Molinex in 11th, Ethan Mann in 12th, Marcus Phelps in 13th, 14th, Palmer Neely, Derek Drake back in 15th. Again, he is looking at a top five overall position finish as far as the championship is concerned, but had championship hopes heading into this third and final moto. As we look back behind him in 16th, Chase Fosna, Austin Smith 17th, Tanner Ward 18th, 19th, Gabe Gutierrez, Trey Fagert rounding out your top 20. You know, something that Carson Brown can certainly take away from this championship and positive notes. And, you know, he does it in the final two motos after the mishap in the first moto. But he walks away with two moto wins. If he can finish this out up front, he'll walk away with two moto wins. And that, too, is still pretty impressive, though it isn't enough to earn him the national championship. It's still very impressive. Like I say, the groundwork's already laid. Folks see what's going on. They know what he's capable of. And I'm sure that it's not going to hurt his chances for sponsorship and advancement in the future by no stretch of the imagination.
All know what he's done here, solidify a reputation and maybe build on a reputation for sure. The ability for this guy to bring the attack, bring the fight all the way to the finish here, Rodney. Let me tell you something. What we have witnessed here this afternoon, man, in all these classes, absolutely incredible. Now, we talked about the likelihood of seeing some real wild scores leading into the overalls, but you know what? What we have found here with the last few classes, very, very consistent riders making their way up onto that podium, fighting it out, and these guys having 1-3s, 4-1s, 3-3 for 6, 7-1 for 8. So these guys right now at about the 17-and-a-half-minute mark, the last lap right now, that number 91 of Carson Brown bringing that thing home right now. Last half a lap out there for that number 91 machine. Jalik Swole answered the challenge many times, was able to get back ahead of that number 91 machine on a couple occasions, actually able to put himself in a position to possibly get out there and win another moto, but Carson Brown right now just too strong, bringing the fight corner after corner, making move after move until one sticks, throwing all kinds of stuff at him, Jeff Cernick, seeing if one of them will stick, and sure enough, it did. The number 91 machine bringing this one to a close right now, waiting on these guys to make their way down to the podium. Going to be just a few minutes. We're going to let Rodney get that thing straightened out down there. But, hey, folks, I told everybody this morning a great big sale going on over at mxtire.com. I mentioned that this morning, but we've got the man himself with us right now. We've got the Ninja Nobby, the man from www.mxtire.com, the Ninja Nobby, Jeff Cernick. Tell us all about it, brother.
Hey, you know what? I got a half a trailer load of tires. We're moving them today. Big discounts on every tire.
Red tag sale on everything.
Fire
sale going on at mxtire.com today. You know, Jason Wygant, when he grabs a set of tire irons, it looks like a ninja with a set of nunchucks, man. I've never seen anybody as talented as Jeff Cernick changing knobbies. That guy has the speed and efficiency of a Ginsu knife.
I don't think you use tire irons. I thought it was just straight knuckles.
Fair hands.
He just rips it right off.
That's what we're talking about. His claws.
He just rips it off. His strongest
claws.
Hands in the game.
And, you know,
fair
he's one of them guys that stuffs the tube in first and then shoves it
and
on the rim.
Still.
A
wow.
Very, very skilled technique. So, right now, Jeff, enjoying the racing this week.
125s. Telling you, this is where the future is.
You better believe it, man. I love it. You know, we've been longtime Tiddler fans. You know, using that term again this week. Tiddler's back in action. Robbie Raynor riding a Tiddler this week. Yep. All kinds of stuff happening. But with you, I love those bikes.
I love the two strokes. Go over and see that 125 at the Suzuki tent. RM125. Maybe year or two down the road, we're going to see a 125 Suzuki on the line also.
Hey, really? They actually are displaying a 125.
Yes. The next person to build
they're
one, Jason Wygant, I'll get it.
They're admitting this. They're like, hey, we actually, yes, we once made two strokes.
Suzuki is, you know, people thought they were slipping a little bit. You know what? Suzuki's back, stronger than ever. Look at the new 125 over there. It's a prototype. Hey, you never know. May come back. There's a survey over there they want you to fill out. It's a three-question survey. You know what? If you want a two-stroke back, go over and see Suzuki, you know, and tell the other manufacturers, look, Suzuki's stepping to the plate. You know, Yamaha's got one, KTM's got one. Maybe we can get a Suzuki back in the line.
Make no mistake, Suzuki's back. Take a walk over through those pits. Take a look at what they're offering right now.
Yep.
Unbelievable resurgence of the brand. Love the retro look myself, to the graphics on the 17 machines. But I can tell you, 125 Tiddler, so useful. Great way to train. Great way to go economically racing with the rebuilds and that type of thing. Young riders, lightweight,
transition
little less
bike.
Beautiful transition bike. That's where we were going.
Hey, guys.
Absolutely.
Down here on the podium as we head to our Racetech podium presentation here, we want to put our hands together for an outstanding performance and an outstanding ride. It'll finish him up, I believe, about second or so in the championship, but he takes a 7-1 and a third moto win. Put your hands together for Carson Brown. Carson, you came out in these final two motos like a man on a mission, man. This the first moto obviously wasn't what you're looking for, but we see now that if you could have put it all together, man, you could have been in a pretty good situation right now.
Yeah, I mean, got off to a good start, and I knew that it was hot out and everybody was going to get tired, so I just kind of followed everybody, and then when they got tired, I just kind of went around and did my thing.
Man, I got to tell you, you look so calculated. Didn't even look like you were pushing whenever you were battling with the Swole out there, but man, you made that pass and you just checked right on out.
Yeah, whenever I can get into my zone, I almost ride mistake free, so just got to get in that zone every time I race and we'll be good.
Congratulations to you on an outstanding performance this week, man. Who do you need to say thanks to?
Oh, man, PMOW and the whole Fry family. My cousin Jensen for coming down and being my mechanic. Oh, man, Motorsport Hillsboro, BBR Motorsports, Pro Circuit, Duval, Fly, Dunlop, thanks, Rob, and Fusion, Spectro, X, Vertex, Moto Stuff, Hot Rod, Cylinder Works, everybody who's helped me out, I can't thank you enough.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about it? Once again, Carson Brown, 7-1-1 here at the Dude Ranch. He takes two gold medals, and we go to our next finisher, which I believe is going to be our third place finisher here in the moto, if I'm not mistaken, and we're going to be talking with Pierce Brown, another Brown up here. Pierce Brown coming into this one with a 2 in Moto 1, a 10 in Moto 2, and this third place position finish here right now. Where's he at? Pierce Brown. All right. Hey, is Pierce over there? Get him over here. Come on, buddy. I know you want to get someplace where it's cool real fast. These guys, they cooled down. Look at this, man. Barely even sweating after this moto. I'm just standing out here. And Pierce Brown is looking like no problem whatsoever. How about it? He takes bronze here in moto number three, Pierce Brown. Pierce, all in all, man, taking a look at the scenario and situations, it wasn't too bad of a finish for you here as far as the week is concerned. I know you were hoping for more, but, man, you rode like rode the wheels off that machine today for sure.
Yeah, I was definitely hoping for more. Pumped with the third overall. Glad I got on the podium. It was definitely a hot one out there.
How you feeling, man? You don't even look like you're tested at all right now, hardly.
I kind of started feeling it halfway through, then just knew I had to push it through. I could rest tonight. So I'd like to thank Red Bull, KTM, TLD, my mom and dad, my mechanic Christian, Scott, Dunlop, everyone from MTF, Colleen, Brian, Gavin, Nihilo, Dunlop, Alpine Star, FMF, Factory Connection, everybody else. Thanks so much.
Pierce Brown, ladies and gentlemen, he takes bronze in the moto. And we're going to bring up Justin Tompkins here, our Bell Helmets Hole Shot Award winner. How about it, ladies and gentlemen? Put your hands together for Justin Tompkins. Justin, congratulations. Or is it Thompson?
Thompson.
Sorry about that. I must have misunderstood. But Justin, congratulations to you. Blistering good start, man. That's the kind of things you're looking for here at Loretta's.
Yeah, for sure. If you don't get the good start, you won't be able to run up with the first guys the whole race, and it'll just mess up your overall finish.
How'd the rest of the race go for you?
It went okay. I made a few mistakes on the first lap, but I managed to stay in the top 10, which is what I wanted.
Well, good. Congratulations to you, man. Where are you from?
South Africa.
So making the trek over here and staying all summer long has been worth it for you then, right?
Yes, for sure.
Who would you like to say thanks to?
I'd like to say thanks to Sebastian Tortelli, CFX Seeds, Flow Motorsports, Thor, my mom, my dad, and my brother.
There you go. Justin Thompson, ladies and gentlemen, taking the Bell Helmets Hole Shot Award. And how about it now? Let's put our hands together for this 2016 Schoolboy 1, 12-16 BC National Champion, Jalik Swole. Jalik grabbing a second place position, and that will earn him a Moto Silver medal here. And congratulations to you, Jalik. A pretty stellar week here for you so far, man. Getting up here on the box, grabbing a championship, and I know this was a pretty challenging class. Talk about it.
Yeah, it was stacked this year. I knew that I had to get good starts and be consistent the whole week, and that's just what I've been focused on, and hopefully I can keep this momentum going to my next moto.
There you go. Third moto this last race out here. What was going through your mind? I'm sure you had a lot of calculations and knew you had things covered, huh?
Not necessarily. You know, I believed in myself, and just listened to Malcolm Stewart, just kept my ears open. Same with Tim Ferry, Evie Ferry, everybody over there. And they helped me out a lot this week. I felt like I was really confident, and I was looking at this like a local race, so I wasn't really nervous. So just came in and focused on my starts being consistent, and that's what got me to win today.
That's what got you the championship for sure. And this man right here coming up to present you with the AMA National Championship, Mr. Kip Bigelow from the American Motorcyclist Association. He not only gets the national number one plate, but also the big shield that is also important for all of our national champions. Jalik Swole, who would you like to say thanks to for helping make this all possible for you here in 2016, man?